So venetoclax is a BCL2 inhibitor that was actually just approved by FDA about 2 weeks ago prior to this meeting in combination with hypomethylating agents and low-dose cytarabine. And in the label, there are patients over age of 75. So these are the patients who previously didn't think we could even treat at all. And also younger patients who are felt to be unfit for standard chemotherapy. So this combination was approved based on the results of the phase 2 study, which tested multiple doses of venetoclax in combination with the HMAs, azacitidine or decitabine, and showed the overall response rate about 67% in either category. And what was most exciting that the median overall survival was 17.5 months, which is exceeding or at least probably doubling the survival with hypomethylating agents alone. So this is very exciting for us, and we were all very happy coming here knowing that this is FDA approved. At this meeting, the updates on this study, both on the low-dose cytarabine and hypomethylating agent combinations, which continue to show a high response rate and improvement of survival. The phase 3 study of randomized study of combination is still ongoing, but nevertheless, FDA felt that the data are strong enough to have it approved even prior to the ASH meeting. In addition, there are now efforts to combine venetoclax with intensive chemotherapy. Our group at MD Anderson have pioneered FLAG-IDA, which is probably the most intense chemotherapy used in younger patients in a relapsed refractory setting. And in the poster today, we show the results of 15 patients treated with a combination where the response rate in the relapse population is 73%. So this is fairly high, and a number of patients transitioned towards stem cell transplantation. We had zero mortality at 2 months of therapy from the toxicity. So we are very excited about this results, and I think this will set the stage for the chemo combinations that are being planned right now in Europe, for example, in several different consortiums. In addition, there were results presented from different schedules of decitabine. Again, our group has shown the data from 10 days decitabine, while in the previous study it was used as a 5-day regimen in combination with venetoclax. And in the ongoing study, the response rate was 92% in elderly patients untreated, which were unfit for induction chemotherapy. So again, this is perhaps improvement over 5 days of regimen, but we have to see the durability of response. So I think these are very exciting studies. In the relapse setting, there will be a presentation today, combination of venetoclax with another targeted agent called Idasanutlin, which is a HDM2 inhibitor that stabilizes P53. And in the final cohort selected for the phase 2 expansion, the response rates are about 50%. Again, these are relapse refractory elderly patients, so it's difficult to treat population. And again, fairly tolerable, and we're excited to take this forward for the future combination trials. So there will be more combination coming up with targeted agents, with standard chemotherapy, but I think these studies have set the stage for the multiple different treatment options for elderly and perhaps for the younger AML patients.